As green section agronomists travel the country, one of the most common complaints we hear from golfers is that our bunkers are inconsistent. The question is, should all bunkers play the same?
Bunkers are an integral part of most golf courses, adding both challenge and beauty to the facility. Most golf historians believe that bunkers were originally formed by livestock digging into sandy hillsides to avoid the cold winds common to lakeside courses. There was little, if any, maintenance on such bunkers. Footprints, plants, and whatever the animals might have left behind resulted in a wide range of lies and shots that challenged the player. Such difficult playing conditions might be why bunkers were classified as hazards in the rules of golf, which they still are today. Bunkers on many courses are highly maintained, often with the primary goal being to create as consistent a bunker shot as possible. To try to achieve consistency, some courses have very intensive bunker maintenance programs. This can include daily hand raking and removal of debris, weekly adjustment of sand depth, and even the hand watering of bunkers to equalize moisture. Of course, such labor-intensive activities demand larger maintenance budgets. In fact, some courses spend more resources per square foot on bunkers than they do on greens. Maintaining bunkers in the pursuit of consistency has gone to an extreme. While we're not suggesting that sheep be put into bunkers anytime soon, it is worth remembering that bunkers are hazards. Maybe we should all remember the words of old Tom Morris, who said, "Bunkers should not be places of pleasure, but are meant to be prisons of penance and repentance." To learn more about bunkers and bunker maintenance, visit usga.org.